Hello, everybody. You are listening to the Lioness Academy podcast. My name is Amanda Forrest, and today I'm doing a really quick episode. Today is the full moon. It is the full harvest moon. I am getting ready to host my very first goddess circle ever, and I'm so excited. I'm finally coming into my full expression of my dharma. I am following my path. I am feeling fully aligned with my purpose, with everything that I have been working on these past few months of my spiritual journey, and it is finally all coming together. And I am gathering women in a sacred space to dance and to express our magic and to talk about things like spirituality and menstrual cycles and crystals and Ayurveda and medicine and everything that we feel not safe to do outside of this sacred space. So this message has been one that has been on my heart for so, so long. And I haven't really found the right way to say it because I've been in the middle of it a lot of the time. You know how they say that the hero's journey doesn't feel like the hero's journey when you're in the middle of it? Well, that was kind of the deal with me. This morning I got a message from a very dear friend of mine who said, "You, Amanda, are so good at fine arts. You're so good at podcasting. You're so good at content creating and photography and ceramics and dancing and singing and performing and speaking. And how do you do all of this stuff and do it well? And what are you really doing? And how do you find a career that works for you, that embodies all of this? And how do you feel like you are not trying to choose between all of these things?" And when I read this message, It honest to God, it just made me laugh, first of all, because holy crap, I don't even recognize how many things I do well. And I don't even recognize the fact that I do all of these things well on a regular basis, and I just cycle through all of them. So firstly, it was like an awakening of like, oh wow, like maybe I should stop doubting myself and actually, you know, embrace the fact that I have these natural abilities that I need to share with other people and that this is my calling and now I'm carving my path. The second thing I realized was that I have always felt like all growing up, like I was falling behind. I always looked at all of the other people in my classes, all my friends, all my classmates, all my cousins, whatever. I always felt like I was the only weird one who didn't have her shit together. And I felt like everybody else did. And it wasn't until I turned 20 and I was a couple of years out of, you know, my regular track of graduating high school and going straight into college. I was out of that. I had paved a different path. I was doing things alternatively. And I realized that in the grand scheme of things, really nobody has their shit together. And that was something that I had not known for the longest time. And I let it control me and I let it destroy me and I let it just stress me the fuck out for no reason because I felt like I was the only one who didn't know what she was doing. And so to answer her question, like, how do I do it all? And what am like, how do I just let myself create, and how do I do all of this stuff? Well, the answer is I literally just make shit up as I go. And I continue to be curious, and I continue to try new things, and I continue to be brave. So I keep putting myself out there. I keep trying new things. I keep putting marketing out. Like, I'm not really great at marketing. I'm not really good at copy or podcast editing or any of that stuff. I have just been brave. And then I have used that bravery and channeled that bravery to say, I am good enough to learn how to do this. And then I just go to YouTube and everything, I swear to God, everything that I know how to do business-wise, because I'm very much a creative being. I am great with, I can draw something just from looking at it. But if you ask me to draft like an Excel spreadsheet, I'm like, bitch, what the fuck? So I've done that though. That's the thing, is that like I've taught myself how to do these things that I didn't know how to do before because I was brave enough to say that I am good enough to learn them. And so like I just keep coming back. And then I continue to believe in myself, because if I tried it one time and then never tried it again because I was like, oh, that didn't work out, I made a mistake, or I'm not very good at that, blah, 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 then I would never grow. When you are growing, when you are expanding your consciousness in order to find your dharma and follow it and fulfill your purpose here on this earth, there are going to be things that you will have to do that you are going to totally freaking suck at. You are going to feel intimidated. You are going to feel not worthy. You're going to feel super scared and super stupid, and it is all freaking normal. You got to get over that fact. And then you got to get into your inner self, your higher self, the one that is telling you all of the directions to go that are right. You are not always listening to that part of yourself, but when you're going to do these new things, you really have to tap into that space and say, I am worthy enough to learn new things. I am worthy enough to spend time doing my creative things that make me happy. I am worthy enough to dance. I am worthy enough for happiness. I am worthy of growth. And so it's not the fact that I'm a total genius and totally perfect at everything that I do. It's not the case. And I struggle a lot with feeling like I have to be perfect. And that's something that I journal on all the time. And it's something that my daily affirmations are about. And it's overwhelming a lot of the time, and I get it. And you're never gonna be freaking perfect. You're never gonna know what you're doing. As soon as you grow to the next level and you feel like you've mastered one aspect of your life, a whole new umbrella of things that you have no idea how the frick to do are going to immediately show up, and you're going to feel like, holy shit, I thought I knew stuff, but now I don't know anything. So it's just a continuous cycle. There is always more shit to learn. I just continue to show up and continue to be brave and continue to believe in myself. And that is how I've seen so many other successful mystic women do it, is that they keep showing up every single day and they keep believing in themselves and they keep telling themselves, I am worthy of growth. I am worthy of this mission because I am important. I am worthy. I am lovable. And I am doing stuff that is going to change the world. So be curious. Find what makes you happy and do more of it. Don't be afraid of failure. Don't be afraid of looking stupid. And be brave. Take risks. Get the fuck out of your comfort zone, because nothing grows there. And I know you've heard that millions of times and that it's super cliche, but it's true. And so there's no better way to say it today. It's super short. And I hope that you have a really wonderful, beautiful, beautiful full moon. And I will see you very, very soon. Thank you, Magic Babes. I love you so much. Thank you for listening to the Lioness Academy podcast. This has been Amanda Forrest, your host. Make sure to follow me on Instagram at AKForrest and also at the Lioness Academy. Follow me for updates, dances, just all kinds of good stuff. And come to my next goddess circle if you are in the San Luis Obispo area. I love you so much. Blessed be. You are amazing and so worthy of love. All right, see you later.